North, south, east, or to where'er we roam, West will remain dear to our hearts, for West will always be our cherished home, even though we soon must part.
Tradition. You know, some people may think that Topeka West is short on tradition, but history tells us otherwise. Take, for instance, the bell we see at all of our home football games. Tradition has it ringing after every Charger score. Ironically, it became even more important to us when it fell silent. You see, it was stolen for a time by rival fans. Of course, homecoming week brought us much in the way of tradition. Each building and some stores in Fairlawn Plaza were creatively decorated by students. Other exciting traditions included a powder puff football game held between the junior and senior girls, a pep rally and bonfire, which was held on campus a night or two before the game. On the day of the game, a big parade, which included multiple marching bands and elaborate floats, cruised through Fairlawn Plaza. Homecoming ceremonies initially only involved a crowning of a queen. A king candidate was added in the late 1970s. The early queens were crowned by prominent local and state officials such as judges, congressmen, and even U.S. senators. In the 1970s, the queen's father did the crowning. Of course, now our tradition has our principal doing the crowning. Recently, we've added athletic and school-wide Hall of Fames to our tradition. And speaking of Hall of Famers, all the music you hear on this video was written and performed by the Topeka West graduates and Hall of Fame members, Kansas. Now it's time for this year's senior class to add to the excellent West tradition. They have selected 6 outstanding homecoming candidates. Let's meet them.
April has been a very smart, hardworking girl since, well, we were kids. You know, she's always caring about others, always making sure everyone's having a good time. I remember this one time we were kids. We'd always invite the little kids in our neighborhood over to our house to play dress up or play with dolls. And she would let them borrow our own clothes. She would, like, let them leave our house and be like, "Oh, it's okay, you can bring it back to us tomorrow." And I'm like, "April, what are you doing? Those are our clothes." She was always sassy, too. Like, if you try to be smart with her, she'll be smart with you back. Like, she will just, it'll just bite you in the butt. That's how sassy she gets. People confuse me and my sister a lot. Me and her, we've grown up, we're like best friends. And she just always knows, like, the right things to say. I mean, even though she's not, I don't know, grown up, she still knows, like, the right words to say. Like, she has the best advice.
I've learned a lot here at West throughout my 4 years, especially with the mentors program here at West and at Stuco. I've learned to become a better April, I suppose, and I'm just so grateful to have met everyone here at West.
He's a giving kid. I mean, he'll give a lot to you, but at the same time, he likes for you to keep your word, and he keeps his word. So if he says he's going to do something, he'll do it. But he used to be, like, real shy, and he didn't really hang out with anybody. When he was in eighth grade, he had to have an emergency appendectomy, and he was chunky then. After he had his surgery, the weight just dropped off. He started lifting weights, and he grew taller, and he likes to have fun, you can tell. He likes to have fun, and he likes to laugh and stuff. But I see him growing into a great young man. He's smart, he's handsome, he has a caring personality. he's going to be a good man, and hopefully he'll be a great father. But he told me he doesn't want kids, but I know that's going to change. I love you, Pops.
One of my favorite moments here at Topeka West throughout my 4 years is the football team and basketball team growing together as like a family and getting our first win. I don't know. I kind of felt like it didn't happen for some reason just because of the fact that we've been down for so long and fighting for it for so long. You just don't know how it feels to be on top.
My favorite homecoming memory was my junior year. We had a big bonfire in the back parking lot, and we always had our pep assemblies on what we called the amphitheater, which is now the hill where the new auditorium sits.
We had this huge pep assembly that all the kids came back for, and it was in the evening. And at the pep assembly, they introduced all the sports teams, just like they do at the pep assembly today, but it was like an hour long. And afterwards, you went out to where they now have like the practice football field, I think. And they had this huge bonfire. It was huge. They set the bleachers up around it, and then the band played next to it, and kids threw stuff in it, which they probably weren't supposed to do, but they did.
My freshman year, I was in Stucco. I was a Stucco rep, and my parents, for some reason, said, yeah, you can build a float at our house. We're close to the school. So everybody brought everything over to our house. We had wood in our yard, paints, and a big trailer in our front yard for a couple weeks while the neighbors were kind of complaining about all the kids being around school. A big trail through the parade, and this is when we still went through Fairlawn Plaza, and the business owners awarded prizes to who had the best floats. And the freshmen that year took second, which was unheard of. We should have taken first, but the seniors always got first, no matter how bad their float actually was.